gosh.
Yeah, it's like golf balls falling from the sky, it looks like. Parts of Texas experienced a hailstorm, as you can see, and you can hear how loud it is. We're bringing in Rob Duns right now. You would think that's not normal for this time of year. Rob, is that kind of strange in Texas to have a hailstorm this time of year or no?
No, this is a severe weather season in the southeast, and big hailstones are a good possibility. You mentioned golf ball size. They were even bigger, up to the size of a hen's egg falling from the sky.
Wow.
So imagine big chunks of ice the size of eggs falling down from the sky.
Enough.
It's no wonder that hail can do so much damage. Now, if you're interested as to just how exactly a hailstone can become the size of an egg, you want to look at the mechanics inside what a thunderstorm can do. Thunderstorms are a buildup of two main drafts, an updraft that sends air rising into the atmosphere, and a downdraft where the air is rapidly pushing down from the atmosphere. Of course, in thunderstorms, you'll have raindrops, and when you have a very strong updraft or rapidly rising air, those raindrops will move into an environment where the air temperatures are below freezing. They turn into little chunks of ice, and as these strong updrafts continue to push them up into the air, they bounce into other hailstones, and they get bigger and bigger and bigger. Now, eventually, gravity will take over, and depending on either the downdraft taking over the storm or the simple weight of the hailstone being too great, it will eventually fall from the sky. But the key here is how strong is the updraft, because typically the stronger the updraft, the longer that hailstone can spend being lofted inside the atmosphere. So here in South Florida, about the biggest hailstone I've ever seen is about the size of a green pea. And when we get hail in Florida, it's kind of a big deal because that's really rare. But in other parts of the United States, like we've been seeing in the southeast, it doesn't take very much for these big, severe storms to produce some really big hail. So in the case of a hailstone that's about the size of an egg, based on what the National Weather Service says, you need an updraft speed of about 70 miles an hour to support a hailstone being as large as the size of an egg. And then it can obviously get a lot bigger. You know, there have been many instances in the past of softball-sized hail falling from thunderstorms. But in that case, the updraft in those specific severe thunderstorms has to be typically in excess of 100 miles an hour. The updraft speed there inside that thunderstorm. Now,